Well, hey everyone, classes, it's me, Mr. Mackay. I'm back to give you your second of our recorded PE lessons. So you still get to see me, so we still get to do some PE together, which is great. Hopefully by now, you've done lesson one. So last week you should have done lesson one, which we were looking at. Can you remember which superhero we were looking at? That's right, it was Ant-Man's, wasn't it? We were looking at Ant-Man's. And can you remember what Ant-Man does? Right, we get small and then tall again, using our hips and our knees and our ankles, didn't we? So we're getting small and tall. That was Ant-Man's special power. Today we're going to meet a different superhero. Some of you have done this one before, but as like I said, with anything, we practice it more than once, don't we? We do things over and over, just like your times tables. You're just going to do it once and then you've done it, you've mastered it. We do it lots of times. So today we are going to do... That's right, it's Iron Man. So we're going to use, as you can see, which part of our body are we going to use today? That's right, we're going to use our hands, because you can see Iron Man has some blasters in his hands, so that's what we're going to use to wake ourselves up and push ourselves away from the floor, just like Iron Man with blasters. So yeah, hopefully by now you've done lesson one with the Ant-Mans, and you've also had a chance to log on to your Jasmine, your real PE at home. If you had difficulty and you couldn't do that, just send me an email. So in your school email address, you will have your login details and a video to show you how to do that. If you haven't done that yet, get on, and if you find it difficult, just let me know and I can help you out, okay? Because it's really, really important that we keep ourselves moving and active. Even when we're stuck indoors or at home, there's still lots of things that we can do. So that's why I'm gonna give you lots of ideas. Okay, so we're going to get onto our skill section then. We're going to look at and recap, because some of you have done this before, so we're going to recap our Iron Man movement. So we're going to make sure we become Iron Man first, and then you can tell me if you can remember how we do Iron Man. Let's go. So, first thing we need to do, making sure that we've got a little bit of space. We've got some sensible clothes on. Probably a good idea to have your trainers on to keep your feet nice and safe. Secure, you're not going to bash into any furniture and stub your toe or anything like that. Right, Iron Man. Got to make sure we've got the Iron Man suit on first, so we've got our super strength. So put your legs in your suit. And your arm. Good. Put that body suit on. And you need to put your power core in, so we've got lots of power to move up some Iron Man presses today. Put your power core in. And Iron Man helmet on. Most importantly though, we need our Iron Man blasters, so shoot me your Iron Man blasters. These are the really important things. Our hands and our arms are super important today. So can any of you remember how we do our Iron Mans? How do we start? That's right, we start lying on the floor. And can you remember where we put our hands? Whereabouts do I put my hands? Near my hips, near my knees, near my chest, near my head. That's right, I'm going to keep them close to my chest, next to my chest. Easy to see with me, I've got a green white line that goes across. So when I'm lying on the floor, my hands next to that green and white line. You can see I've got my fingers pointing up away from me, up towards my head, or even like that, slightly away from my head. So that's how Iron Man's going to lie down. So get our glasses ready. When Iron Man sleeps, he sleeps on his front with his legs nice and straight. And don't have your feet close next to each other or crossed over. You've got your feet with a little bit of space, a little bit of gap. Look, not next to each other, a little bit of gap. Then I'm going to wake myself up, ready? And then I'm going to hold it still. And back down. One more time. Good job. Use those blasters to blast the floor away. So remember, there are two ways to do this. This is the trickier way. The trickier way is to blast your whole body and your legs at the same time. So watch me, I'm doing my whole body at the same time. So just my hands and my feet stay on the floor. Look. And then let myself down slowly. So, as you can see, that was a trickier version. If that is too tricky,
or you can only do like one or two of those. Here is a slightly easier version. So I'm gonna blast, but I'm just gonna blast my body first, and then I can lift my knees off. So I finish in the same position, but I still go down as in slow. Try to go down slow. So I'm gonna go blast, blast. I don't want to see you doing this, lots of little ones. Okay, we've got to go all the way. So even if you have to do this one, we can go up, up, down, up, up, down. Okay, if you can do full Ironmans like this, brilliant. And then down, down. Okay, good job. So you've got two choices, whether you want to do the full Ironman with your body and your knees at the same time, which is trickier, or if you want to do just a tricky version, so you can do your in two parts. So you do your body and then your knees. But we start and we finish in the same position. Doesn't matter if you do just the tricky version or the trickier version. You just do finish and start in the same position, okay? And when we do our movements, our special movements, which is our Ironman is our special movement today, do we do it fast or do we do it slow and controlled? Yeah, that's right, we do it slow and controlled. We want good movement. And do I do lots of little movements or do I make them slower but bigger movements? Good, slow and big. So I don't want this. I don't want you doing lots of little ones like this. That's little movements. So I want you to go all the way down and all the way up. All the way down and all the way up. Okay? Cool. So that is how we're going to do our Ironmans. Okay? Again, really important, we've got a water bottle. So if you haven't got a water bottle yet, maybe just pause the video, go and get one. Ideally in a water bottle or a plastic cup, just in case you knock it over, you don't want to knock a glass over. Really, really important, we keep drinking. Right, gonna do a little bit of a warm up and then we're gonna get straight into our workout. So quick warm up, doing some gorillas and some lizards, okay? Right, I know some of you are really good at gorillas. They're a little bit tricky, so we'll go through them first. So, gorillas. Remember, do we go forwards and backwards or side to side? That's right, side to side. And which parts of my body do I use? Yeah, hands and feet. So look, I'm gonna put my hands to the side. So I'm gonna go hands, feet, hands, feet. And back the other way. Hands, feet, hands, feet. So I'm swinging my body sideways, let's go. Okay, side to side. Keep going. Really good exercise to warm our bodies up. And one more. Good job, stand up, shake it out. Good job. Right, then we're also gonna do some lizards. But we'll do gorillas one more time. Right, squat down, hands to the side. Gorilla, gorilla, and the other way. Gorilla, gorilla. Good, because we are using our arms quite a lot, we're also gonna do some lizards in our warm up. So we're gonna stand up. Get into our Ironman position, at the top of our Ironman, but just moving our hands and feet a little bit. Just move our hands and feet a little bit to warm up those ankles and wrists. There we go. And a bit more forwards. And backwards. And forwards. Oh, my bottom down a bit, my bottom's a bit too high there. And backwards. Good job. Woo. Stand up, check it out. Just about ready to go. Let's do some arm circles forwards. And arm circles backwards. Pat yourself on the back. You look at that. Pat yourself on the back. And my arms go a little floppy. Stretch them out a little bit. Good job. Hands on the hips. And do one big circle one way and one the other. I'll do that a couple of times. One circle one way. Good job. Right, so like last week, we are going to do three different exercises
And we're going to do them four times. We're going to do four rounds, which is going to give us how many minutes? That's right, 12 minutes. 12 minute workout. Three lots of exercises, four times. So we're going to do 12 minutes of exercise. Can you guess what the first and most important exercise is? That's right, it's going to be our Ant-Mans. So first exercise is going to be our Ant-Mans. Then, also using our hands, we are going to do some bear crawls. So we're going to bear crawl forwards and backwards, like we did in our warm-up last week, using our whole body, using our tummy muscles, yeah, to move like a bear. And then our third and final one, to get our heart pumping nice and fast, we're going to do some super speedy running on the spot. Okay, super fast running on the spot. So those are our three exercises that we are going to do. So I'm just going to get the music going. Make sure that you have got a bit of space. You've got your water bottle. So we're nearly ready to go. Right. So remember, first exercise is going to be Ant-Man. Shake it out, shake your arms out, shake your legs out, shake your whole body out, get ready to go. Right. So remember, we start lying down, hands by our chest. Get ready to go. Sleeping, 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 and wake up. Hold it, hold it, hold it, and down. And this bit can be fast, slow all the way down.
Good job. Breath back. Second, what was our second exercise? That's right there. Okay, ready there. On, keep your arms in the shape. Keep your legs in the shape. You feel like you can go quick with your bare balls this time. Push.
Good. done three sets.
So we've only got one left. Okay, going to do one more round. All right, one more round to do. Have a breath.
A breath.
Take some breath. In and out through your nose. Get ready. Last set of Ironman. We're keeping that body nice and straight. Let's go. So look at the straw from our track, so keep it nice and straight. And you remember, you'll have a bit of a gap between your fingers and your lips to get too close together.
Give you one more night.
Good, keep going. Slow and controlled. Don't rush it.
Million nights just like this.
Really well, it's not. Come on, let's do two more. One.
Mama, please don't want
two. Down. Good job. Really well, super hard. Now, last exercise. Bear claws. And a super sprint finish. And we are done. Let's get ready.
Just going to do a little bit of a cool down, okay? Let's cool down and stretch out. We've done lots of sitting at your computer, which is why we are making sure that we're using some upper body and back exercises. So we're going to stretch all of that out. So we've got to make sure when we're sitting at the computer, we've got a good posture. See the line on my t-shirt when it's nice and straight? Don't want to be sat like that on the computer. So we're going to stay nice and straight, nice and tall. So we're going to stretch our thing out. Right. First of all, I'm going to stand up. Standing up. I'm nice and tall. Arms out to the side, and we're going to push them to the walls away. Walls are closing in, you've got to push them away. Push them away. Stretch out those back and arm muscles. Oh, ceiling's coming down. Check ceiling. Squeeze those shoulder blades. Rock the hips forward and push your shoulders back.
some stretching on the back. So just above your bottom, you should feel it stretching there. Now you can feel your bottom muscles stretching as well. Do you remember what your bottom muscles are called? Gluteus maximus, your bottom muscle. So from here, I'm keeping my feet, my hands in the same place, but I'm going to rock my bottom backwards towards my heels, and then I'm going to push my head towards the ground and stretch out my top part of my back again. Push the head towards the ground. And forward again. So keep my hands and my feet in the same position. Hips forward, head back. Stretching my lower back. All that sitting down at the computer, really going to stretch it out. Rock it back, head down. Don't worry about that beeping, it's just 10 minutes to be finished, but we're going to do one more of these. And really stretch our backs out. And again, forward, keep your hands and feet in the same position. Hips forward, shoulders back. Stretch it out.
Right, good job guys. Really, really good job. Oh, let me just turn this music off so you can hear me. Right, as I said at the start, it is super, super important that we keep doing some moving around, whatever way you can do that. So after you've done your lessons on the computer, can you get out and do some moving around? Can you get in the garden for a bit? Can you go and do some skipping? You found this video on the YouTube channel. You can go back and look at some of the videos that I recorded back in the spring for the first lockdown, and you could do some of those if you wanted, because there are some of those videos, there's some other lessons for your age group, or there are some challenges that you could do, so you could challenge yourself, or brothers or sisters, or mums or dads. There's lots of little challenges that you can do. Okay, so there's lots of activities that you can do. Also, by now you should have got your, well, you will have had an email from me with your login details for Jasmine Online, okay, which is, covers a lot of the things that we do in our lessons. See the posters behind me are the real PE posters, so you've got your real PE at home resources. If you haven't been on there yet, make sure you do, because there's a video to watch that I've sent you in that email to show you what activities we are doing each week. So each week I'll post a video on Google Classroom. Just a short 2 or 3 minute video to show you what activities to focus on. If you want to do more in that section, you can. Okay, it's up to you if you want to do extra, but you can do the activities that I will show you. Okay, so you have 2 lessons a week. First lesson of the week is with me, that we've just done your video, and your second lesson of the week is to get on to Jasmine and complete the challenges that I have set you. And again, you can do some more challenges on Jasmine if you want. You can do some challenges from the YouTube channel. You can go back and do some of the lessons from the spring. So there's lots and lots of opportunities for you to get moving. And most of it you should be able to do on your own. Yeah? You shouldn't need Mummy or Daddy to help you. Just click play or click on the activities and it will all explain it for you. Okay? But if you do have any problems getting on, send me an email and I will help you out to make sure that we all keep moving and keep fit. Okay? So take care, and I will see you next week. Goodbye.